Imagine sitting in a sweltering car on a blazing summer day. Now picture that, but with a high-tech fighter jet. How do you test a Gripen to operate in the harshest conditions, and why is it necessary? Welcome to the world of hot weather flight testing. In previous episodes of Let's Talk About Tech, we headed north to the Arctic Circle to learn how a Gripen jet is tested to withstand even the coldest of winters. And this time, we're heading to Brazil to learn how the aircraft is tested for hot and humid climates in Latin America. This is crucial because power system components like batteries, capacitors, conductors, and generators are heat sensitive and require thermal management. Of course, you don't want heat to affect performance when it matters. These tests are essential to ensure that aircraft can withstand external heat and continue operating at peak performance. For this dry test, a Gripen was left out in the sun for hours, mimicking the conditions of a car during a hot summer day, before taking to the skies. Over 3 days, the pilot took off with the jet in temperatures averaging 32 degrees Celsius, conducting one-hour flights to allow engineers to evaluate the aircraft's performance in Brazil's high temperatures. Equipped with around 800 additional sensors, the test aircraft collects data both on the ground and throughout the flight. This information is transmitted in real time to a telemetry room where engineers monitor the tests, analyzing internal temperatures and system behaviors. After landing, brake temperatures are measured, the aircraft is cooled, and system data is downloaded for further analysis. In humid conditions, hot air condenses, similar to how an AC unit works in your home. For an aircraft, this can lead to significant water accumulation, which must be drained to prevent issues. Ground crews inspect the aircraft post-flight to ensure no water has gathered in critical areas. The hot and humid test flights involve flying to high altitudes where the air is cooler, and then rapidly descending to low altitudes with hot, humid air to create condensation. This sudden change can cause the cool aircraft surface to gather moisture, making it crucial to defog the windshield so the pilot maintains visibility. At Let's Talk About Tech, you get to be co-creators. What do you want to learn about defense technology or tech in general? Drop your questions in the comments below. And if you're new here, check out Saab.com and hit that subscribe button to stay updated.